The life is good, but how do I model these detailed cutouts? Like this, for example. I see it literally everywhere, but I don't know where to start, and the subdivision workflow doesn't give me the results I want. This looks spectacular, by the way. Oh, thank you very much, actually. I also think that looks great and gives me the 80s nostalgic vibe. And let's try to unpack the modeling strategy in a few minutes. To tell the truth, personally, I have problems with sub-D modeling such shapes, because you have to plan many things in advance, and you have to direct the topology flow for all the edges, and it requires a certain mental effort to pre-plan those things and to make sure you do it the right way. And on top of that, the mesh ends up being pretty dense, so let's try something different. Let's start with the plane. Bevel the corners a little bit by hitting Ctrl-Shift-B. What I'm going to do next is start drawing shapes on top of this. I will use geometry instead of splines because I have easier time tweaking it. I find tweaking the Bezier splines handles a little bit unintuitive sometimes, so for this task I will resort to just using regular vertices and edges. And here I created a circle with 64 edges, and let's turn it into this capsule shape. And no practical need to restrain ourselves in terms of potential details that we can throw in. Blender can handle it pretty well. I tried to crash it and to cheat it somehow, but Blender prevailed. Anyway, those shapes are meant to be projected onto the plane, onto the underlying mesh. We can experiment with the style of the shapes, maybe add some double outlines, and we can copy the stuff around to save ourselves a little bit of time. Here I added a bunch of circular holes, which are pretty tedious to add in the sub-D workflow, and text with deleted faces, and in order to make it work, we need to delete all polygons and leave just edges. And we select it all and shift-click on the plane. It needs to be selected last. In other words, it needs to be the active mesh. Then I'm hitting Tab to enter the edit mode, and I'm going Mesh, Knife Project. And what is crucial, we are using the top orthographic view for projecting those details. That's really important. It's easy to accidentally start projecting from the perspective view, and it will be a mess. And as you can see, everything went well, and we have successfully projected all the shapes that we have designed for this asset onto the main mesh. Wow, it's awesome. And from here, we can either separate those things and design them as separate meshes, or we can extrude, inset, and just tinker around with the geometry to add a little bit of depth to this thing. And I find it to be extremely liberating to work in this what you see is what you get fashion. You design the shapes as you see them without the additional step of Catmull-Clark subdivision, and then you just slap it onto the geometry. Of course, it requires a certain degree of responsibility, but just make backups so you can roll back and repeat the process with slightly different shapes. So yeah, that's how this detailed panel cutout look can be achieved in Blender.